नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, tanidars, kotaris, sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, two-way video conferencing, having Nainadiksha. Cities sitting with us through two-way video conferencing, having Nainadiksha. Singapore, Hyderabad, Dakota Dunes, Winston-Salem, Romania, Tallahassee, Florida, Dubai, Charlotte, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Bogota, Colombia, Guadeloupe, Seattle, Enriching Temple, Indrani, New Jersey, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, Oklahoma, Somanatham, Phoenix, London, Kashi, and some more cities are joining. I welcome every one of you with my love and respects. Lot more cities have joined in two way. St. Louis, Tirumala, Ohio, Pujananda, Chennai, LA Downtown, Toronto, Kailasam, Oman, Sivagangai, Ozur, Sally Spring, Winston, Houston, Texas, Vancouver, Nityananda Nagaram, Hyderabad, yes, and Chennai. Yes, I can see. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I have to answer a few questions before entering into Upanishads. Some people are expressing, Swamiji has entered only first Upanishad Sutra. It is mind-blowing. Some are expressing it is just going beyond our head or understanding. See, if you feel it is going beyond your head, you are not able to understand. The solution is watching the satsang again 2-3 times, not telling me to reduce or dilute the strength of what I am delivering. Understand, I am not Anasin Metasin Guru, giving few kriyas, techniques, some goody-goody messages. Love everyone, your problems will be solved. As if nobody knows or what, how to love is the problem. Now, I am not the guru who gives some kind of a nice to hear advice, feel good, feel techniques. I do give some of the life solutions, but I am not just that alone. Please understand. If I am not revealing the Akashic records during the Upanishads, then when am I going to express? When am I going to reveal all these truths? So I am very clear. No way the satsangs Upanishad series is going to get diluted. It is only going to get more and more stronger. And as I said, I am not interpreting. I am just intercepting the conversations happened originally when these Upanishads were revealed. The pretext, context and afterward, foreword, content, afterward, all that which is related to Upanishads, I am downloading and reading it out, sharing it with all of you. You can't ask me to dilute it. If you wanted it to be diluted, ask the Upanishadic Rishis. It's not in my hands. So understand, it is something not in my hands. Please understand, I am neither a feel-good feeling teacher nor a revolutionist. No. I am a spiritual being expressing and actively establishing the Dharma. Cosmic understandings about life. Helping everyone to live Advaita. So if you feel you are not able to understand, you are not able to internalize, please watch the satsang again and again, 2-3 times, then you will understand. Let me enter into the mantra. ईशावास्यमिदग्गुं सर्वम् यत्किञ्च जगत्यां जगत् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीता मा कृतः कस्य स्विद्धनम् The translation is, by the consciousness filled must this all be, whatever moving thing there is in the ever moving world, with this renounced you may enjoy, covet not the wealth of anyone at all. Listen. Yesterday I was expanding these 4 words. I'll expand that 4 words little more deep and then move to the next. Listen. Perception. Whatever your senses can perceive in a limited time and space. Second, fact. Your senses perceiving with a more time and space. Truth with a lot more time and space, even your perception evolves. truth, reality is, existence as it is, beyond your perception and time and space. Yesterday I was giving an example, perception. Earth is flat, sun is going round the earth. Fact, no, earth is round and earth only is going around the sun. Truth, earth is not exactly round. It's more like orange fruit, little pressed above and below, and sun goes round the earth. Please listen. In the perception also you felt sun goes round the earth. In truth also sun goes round the earth. But both are not one and the same. Here, you know it with a clear understanding. Sun goes round the earth in few billion years because this whole sun family is not stagnant. The whole sun family is moving around. Whole solar system is moving around, centered on something. So in that way, sun will go around the earth at least once in billions of years. The reality is the shape of the earth should be seen with the Google Earth map. You can't describe it as a round or little orange fruit type. No. No description is possible. See it as it is, and both sun and the earth are going around each other. Earth goes round within 1 year period, sun goes round within few billion years. Listen, life is all about evolving your cognition from perception to fact, fact to truth, truth to reality. That's all. It has nothing to do with so-called bliss, love, renunciation, devotion, yoga, nothing. All these are side effects. When your perception evolves to fact, you may suddenly become meditative. You may suddenly become yogic. You may suddenly become loving. You may suddenly become blissful. But life itself, the purpose of life itself is to evolve from perception to fact, fact to truth, truth to reality. When you are moving from fact to truth, you may suddenly become active. You may suddenly become more loving. You may suddenly become blissful. You may suddenly lose your cunningness. I am seeing that happening after I started Upanishads in so many people. People are losing their hypocrisy. People are losing their anger, violence. The highest form of violence is you deciding you will not be useful or productive to anybody. That's the highest form of violence. You deciding, I will not be useful. See, when you are angry towards your boss, I will not be useful to his aim, his goal. Same way, only when you are angry with yourself and Sangha, Guru, whatever you see. See, when you are angry with yourself, you will be angry with everything, everybody, everyone. Only then you will decide, I will not be useful or I will not make any of their declarations into reality. Love means making yourself as a catalyst for everyone's reality. Nothing more can be done to that extent. Not only you should perceive, whatever you can, you have done. Everyone should feel, whatever you can, you have done it for making everyone's reality. That is what is love. I am seeing more and more people dropping hypocrisy, becoming loving, because many of your perceptions are moving towards fact, facts are moving towards truth, truths are moving towards reality. That's all is life. That's all is life. Cognition. Cognition. Moving from perception to fact. Fact to truth. Truth to reality. Reality is Isha. Listen. Upanishads declares very clearly. Upanishads declare very clearly. Consciousness fills all this. Ishavasyam idagum sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat. This one verse answers so many doubts created by materialists, the so-called rationalists. Are the so-called irrational rationalists, paguttarivu. In Tamil we use the word. Tamilian Paguttarivu people are, the Tamilian atheists are not even rationalists, they are irrational rationalists. Listen, my pronunciation, Ishavashyam, is also Patabetha. How I heard from my masters, I am repeating, but actually it is Ishavashyam. Ishavashyam is not Vashya. My masters, they use the same Sha to Vasya also. I am retaining the Padabheda as it is, as a respect and reverence to my master's way of pronouncing it. In Vedic tradition, it is allowed. The Padabheda, which you heard exactly from your master, is supposed to be retained as it is. So even though letter here, the Isha, that Sha is different, Vasyam, that is not the Sha, but because I heard from my masters, Isha Vasyam idagum sarvam, I am retaining it. So all my disciples are requested to retain the same Patabheda of my masters. It's a way of giving respect to the teacher. The highest place given for the masters and teachers in our Vedic tradition. Even if there is pronunciation difference, it is accepted and revered as Padabheda of that master, and I do wanted to keep the tradition. Listen, nothing purifies you like truth. Just simply sitting and giving advice to human beings is useless. After doing that for a decade, I realized it. Sitting and giving advice to human beings is useless. Understand? Telling them, be more loving, be more blissful, be more caring, be non-violent, all this is just useless, utter useless, not even 1% useful. If at all you are really sincere in helping yourself and people, others, do not do the stupid thing of empty advices. I tell you, whenever I moved people from perception to fact, fact to truth, truth to reality, all the best things need to happen to people have started happening. They become automatically more loving, more caring, more intelligent, more non-violent, more enriching. I tell you, throughout this Upanishad series, I am going to do only this, moving you from step by step to the higher levels of existence. Automatically, all the good things will happen to you and by you. I am not moral teacher. Please understand. my teachings may lead you to become more moral. My aim is leading you to higher and higher reality. Asato ma satkamaya. My purpose is to lead you to asato ma satkamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityorma amritamgamaya. The side effect may be bliss. You may become more blissful. Side effect may be intelligence. You may become more intelligent. Side effect may be thousands and thousands of auspicious qualities. You may become good moral person, but my aim is to lead you from unreality to reality. Asatoma sadgamaya, tamasoma jyotirgamaya, mrityorma amritamgamaya. Understand experientially moving you from perception to fact, fact to truth, truth to reality. Helping you to live Advaita. The best way to listen to Upanishads should be morning you wake up, just wash yourself, come and drop your body in the presence of the Master. Listen, listen, listen. After that whole day, just digest, 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 not doing any work related to mind other than this digestion. And if at all needed, doing little physical work like a gardening or agriculture, body can work, some cleaning of the deity or doing little agriculture or gardening, but mind should not work. Mind should only be working on these great truths, digesting it and falling into that space in the night as a sleep. This is the best way to listen to Upanishads. Anyone who listens to Upanishad in this way, even for 3 months, will experience living Advaita. Mind should not be engaged in any other mental activities which requires you to move away from contemplating on these truths. Body can be engaged. You can just be doing some gardening. You can be doing some agriculture work. Body can be engaged. But mind not getting engaged in anything moving out of this contemplation on Upanishads. And enriching is never moving out of Upanishads, don't worry. If you are working on enriching, it is perfect. It only strengthens your understanding about Upanishads. Other than that, not doing any other mental actions, activities, and digesting. Nothing like it. Nothing like it. Not doing mental activities but doing only physical activities. Not doing mental activity means even the unnecessary wandering should not be there. It should, mind should be engaged in thinking, contemplating on these great truths you heard. It should be engaged. That is why I am encouraging vada pradivada, debates, contemplating. Anybody can devote just 3 months. Especially this first 3 months, I am going to be exploring on Ishavasya Upanishad. After Isha, Kena. After Kena Upanishad, Kata. Just the best and greatest truths revealed. But I don't think in 3 months we will be finishing Kena, Kata, all those Upanishads. Maybe we may finish Ishavasya Upanishad. Because I am looking at least next 2 years, I'll be expanding on Upanishads. Ishavasya Upanishads alone is 18 verses. And I welcome and invite everyone all the ashrams all over the world are now open for everyone to come and listen to Upanishads, contemplate whole day without doing any mental work, doing just some physical activities like gardening or agriculture or just cooking. And I take the responsibility of providing for your needs during this period. As per the Vedic tradition, master is supposed to beg and take care of the disciples' needs like food, shelter, clothes, medical care, the basic needs. So I commit with all of you, as per the Vedic tradition, anyone can come and be in our campuses wherever we have place to accommodate. Of course, this campus is enough to accommodate even few thousand people. You can come, study minimum 3 months. If you want to stay further, and listen to further Upanishads, I welcome you. You will not be put to do any mental activity which is not supposed to be done when you are digesting these great truths other than contemplating on it. This is what the ideal life I propose, especially when you are internalizing Upanishads. Listen to morning satsang and spend a little time on contemplating on it, just to keep yourself awake. Do some physical activity, otherwise you will fall asleep or you will just drift away into your worrying incompletions. To keep yourself away from it, you can do some simple physical activity like gardening or agriculture or cooking. Physical activity where mind is not required to be engaged in certain actions. Our mind is not required to be engaged in any activity away from contemplating on Upanishads. Then have debates on Upanishads. And you can watch the satsang retelecast. And again, once the sun sets, having an active, powerful debate, non-violent, active, powerful debate. See, why I say non-violent? You should not be taking a stand just because you took that stand. You should move to the different stand only if you are sincerely convinced. See, without sincerely convinced, you should neither move to the other stand. If you are sincerely convinced, you should not have the blockage of ego. No, I already took this stand, how can I change? No. Without having the ego, I took this stand, how can I change? You should be able to change, and you should change only if you are sincerely convinced, not otherwise. That is what I call active non-violent debate. I visualize every evening after sunset in front of Vaidyasarovar. Hundreds and hundreds of seekers sitting as two batch, Vyasa and Shankara, and debating on Upanishads. Listening to these debates sincerely, even birds and flies and bees getting enlightened. And because of their feet touching the lotus in the Manasarovar, even the honey in the lotus becomes nectar. Because that nectar falls into the Manasarovar water, anybody takes bath in that water or gives the Shraddha to their elders in that water, even they getting liberated. All those liberated beings deciding to visit this Kailasa and taking birth, coming to our Gurukul as incarnations and studying. And those incarnations again continuing the debate on the banks of Vaidyasarovar and liberating more and more beings. Maybe a little poetic, but this is the way I wanted this place to be, and I know it will be. Active non-violent debate. Understand? Not being active is useless, dead. I have seen when debates happen, there will always be 20 people. What is there for me? Let them debate. Finally, whatever is conclusion, I'll understand that. No, you will never understand the conclusion unless you are actively into the thinking process. Unless you are actively into the thinking process, no, you can't catch the truths in the end. No, You can't just see the climax of the movie and understand the whole movie and enjoy the whole movie. No. You need to watch from the beginning to catch the climax. And I also request all the mahans in all the ashrams, please lead the vada pradivada every day. Have some time dedicated for it. Whoever comes, let them come and participate. It should be such a non-violent, active participation. Everyone should be participating and non-violent. So from today, in the Gurukul, we will have a debate for Balasans, Balakotaris, Balmahans. They will have their own debate. And in front of Vaidyasarovar, the seekers, disciples, devotees who are residing in this campus and who are internalizing Upanishads can have everyday debate. Non-violent active debate. Vada Pradivada. Shastra Vichara. Shastra Chai Pe Charcha. And I invite anyone who wants to internalize the Upanishads in this way to Bidadi or any of our campuses where we have accommodation facility to come and stay and internalize. The program is absolutely free, and as per the Vedic tradition, the Guru is supposed to beg, collect all the needs and support the disciple, and I am capable of that and I will do it. When Upanishads are taught, this is the way, this is the tradition which was practiced. So we will do that and have Vakyartha Sadas. That's a technical term for debating on the great spiritual scriptures. Vakyartha Sadas. We will have Vakyartha Sadas every evening on the banks of Vaidyasarovar. Whoever wants to participate, please come and participate. Today again, the subject for Vakyartha Sadas is perception, fact, truth, reality. Debate on it, have Vakyartha Sadas on it. And I am encouraging Vakyartha Sadas everywhere. All the Mahans should lead Vakyartha Sadas everywhere in all our ashrams, temples, gurukuls, schools, vidyalayas, and in all the campuses. Through Vakyartha Sadas, you will internalize and intranalize these great truths again and again and again. We will have the Vakyartha Sadas as per the tradition with the bitter leaf, bitter nut, lime paste. That's a traditional way of having the debate. We will have the Vakyartha Sadas as per the tradition every day. With this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 080-2727-9999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.